Hi, good morning, fellow Toastmasters and guests. I am Toastmaster Manas, Manas Nayak, to be your servant at arms for today's meeting. Now I am opening Speaker Community Toastmaster Club's 33rd meeting officially. So today is a wonderful day as Speaker Community Toastmaster Club's HUT committee did a great job in this pandemic. Even I also did not know today morning what I am going to do. So yes, obviously, most of the role players today's to-do list must have got disrupted. But kudos to all of us that we achieved a milestone. Keep the show going. Show must go on. So let me share some instructions which we need to follow in this online meeting environment. I request all of you to rename yourself. All Toastmasters can prefix TM Tango Mango to your name, and guests can prefix guest. I also request all the speakers and role holders to prefix their role to their name so that it is easy to identify them. I give you 10 seconds for this activity. If any hurdles, then just let me know. I will happy to help you. I would request you not to type in the chat box when a speaker speaking as it disturbs the speaker. You can use the private chat to provide feedback. You all are requested to keep your video on if you are not moving around or not sipping any drinks, and audio on mute in case you are not speaking. If you are a speaker, then please ensure you pin the timer or confirm that the same is visible at all times to you. You can connect with me for any technical glitch. I am your sergeant at arms as well tech master for today's meeting. All speakers are requested to do a quick audio video check before they start the speech. I will guide you on the setting if you require. So you can network after the meeting. Here we can display hi fi or namaste when taking over or leaving from role. So let me share the mission of the club. We provide a supportive and positive learning experience in which members are empowered to develop communications and leadership skills, resulting in greater self-confidence in personal growth. So now it's a time for me to invite our presiding officer. It's my great pleasure to introduce our presiding officer, who is going to officially begin today's meeting and also talk to us on our club business. So in today's meeting, we have a gorgeous, multi-talented, dynamic chef consultant with us who loves art and chocolate cakes. So nowadays, she's on a pitch to explore new things. So it is our privilege to have her as a presiding officer for the day. So now, without any delay, let me invite our presiding officer with a round of applause. She is none other than our VP membership, Toastmaster Sarin. So over to you, Sarin.
Thank you, Manas, for that energetic, full of energy that made us also lively introduction. It's October. We have successfully completed 9 months with Speakers Community Toastmasters Club. Welcome to the 33rd meeting of Speakers Community Toastmasters Club. And since we don't have any guests, I'm sure they wanted to join, but they had some other commitments. But since they are not there, let me ask you a question. Any guesses, what is that one thing that stands between your dreams and its accomplishment?
You yourself.
Okay, any other guesses?
Time.
Okay. Well, it's true, but it's not just time. It's not just me, myself. It's not just the luck, but the discipline that you add. Discipline is the bridge that is between your dreams and its accomplishment. You have to choose to show up every time, no matter what your schedule is, no matter what your mental health is, no matter how emotional you are. Because discipline is the key that leads to success. And I commend and I commend the conviction that we all have here to show up on this day and take up various roles when we were struggling with some of the role players that we had. This shows how much disciplined we are in our paths and how much we want to accomplish it. We are all in the right path, and no matter how hard the road is with so many potholes, but I see that the results will always be priceless. With that note, let me pass on this stage to our very own young, spirited, zestful, full of creative ideas, our VPPR, and also the Toastmaster of the day, Toastmaster Anisha. Over to you, Anisha.
Thank you, Toastmaster Shirin. Manas, can you spotlight me? Guys, can you able to hear me?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you, Toastmaster Shirin, for the introduction. Good evening, everyone. It's a pleasure to serve as the Toastmaster of the day. Before introducing the theme of the day, let me explain the agenda of the meeting. Toastmaster meeting in general is divided into three sessions. The first session is the prepared speeches. The second session is the table topic session. And the last is the evaluation or the feedback session. To help me in the meeting, I have my three pillars. They're also called as tag team, timer, R counter, and reminder. Now I call all the role players to introduce themselves. So our today's first role player is Toastmaster Dheeraj, who's playing timer.
Thank you, Toastmaster Anisha. Welcome, Toastmaster of the day, fellow Toastmaster and the guest. I'm the timer for today's session. As the timer, it's my duty to time the prepared speeches, table topics, and evaluations. For prepared speeches, the time allotted varies as per the project requirement and will be stated by the evaluator. For instance, for icebreaker speech, the time is 4 to 6 minutes. For normal speeches, the time is 5 to 7 minutes. For table topic, the time allotted is 1 to 2 minutes. And for evaluation, the time allotted is 2 to 3 minutes. Speaker must meet the specified time limit to qualify for the award at the end of the meeting. I will be displaying a green screen card at the end of the minimum qualifying time, yellow at the midpoint, and the red screen after the end of the maximum qualifying time. For prepared speeches and the evaluations, there is a 30-second grace period both before and after the minimum and maximum qualifying time, respectively. For table topic, there is a grace period of 30 seconds, and that is after the maximum qualifying time. I will report the time when called upon. Thank you, and over to you, Toastmaster.
And our second role player is our counter. That I'm playing the counter. As the counter, I will note words and sounds that are used as crush or fillers by the speaker. During the meeting, I will listen to the crush words such as and, as well, but, so, you, or you know. I will also listen for filler sounds such as or. I will note when a speaker repeats a phrase such as I, or this means. And long and short pauses. I will give my report when called by the journal evaluator. Thank you. And our next role player is Grammarian. Grammarian is played by Toastmaster Amey.
Thank you, Toastmaster of the day. I welcome all fellow Toastmasters and guests. As a grammarian, it's my responsibility to pay close attention to all speakers, listening carefully to their language usage. I will take note of any incorrect usage of grammar, as well as any good usage of words, quotes, sayings, or thoughts. So as a grammarian, let me introduce you to the word of the day today. The word of the day is conviction. It means that a strong belief or opinion where you believe that you can do something or create something. That is conviction. And the phrase of the day is beat around the bush. It means that sometimes we avoid saying what we want, but since we are not comfortable, we don't do this. So that is the meaning of the phrase of the day today, that is beat around the bush. Okay, each speaker is encouraged to use the word of the day. I will give my report when called upon by the general evaluator. Thank you, and over to you, Toastmaster Anisha.
Thank you, Toastmaster Amit. Before we start with the prepared speeches, let me talk about the theme of the day. Today's theme is obstacles to opportunities. Considering the theme of the day, I would like to tell you a short story. Once upon a time, there was a wealthy and a curious king named Chatur. He always used to surprise his subjects with his action. Once he decided to rest to test his fellow subjects, one night he placed a huge stone right in the middle of the road, which directly goes towards his court. Early in the morning, when King Council was about to start, few of his fellow council members were the first to come. Then were the king's wealthiest merchants, then subjects, whose problems were to be solved. Surprisingly, none of them tried to remove the stone. Some started blaming the king for not maintaining the road. All subjects loved their king a lot. There was a potter in the town. The potter was an amazing artist. He made a beautiful statue of King Chatur, and that day he came to present it to the king. As soon as he was about to enter the court, he saw the stone. He put the statue aside and tried to move the stone to the side, and finally, after a lot of effort, he finally succeeded. A small bag was lying beneath the stone. He then went inside the court towards the king. Before telling you what the king said, let us start with the prepared speech session. Today, our first speech is going to be given by Toastmaster Shreya, and to evaluate her speech, we have Toastmaster Manas. I call upon Toastmaster Manas to read Toastmaster Shreya's objective. Toastmaster Manas, over to you.
Yeah, thank you, Toastmaster of the day. My target speaker, Toastmaster Shreya, is going to present her Level 1 Project 2. The purpose of this project is for the member to demonstrate that she has applied the feedback received from her first speech and present a speech on any topic, receive feedback, and apply the feedback to the next speech. Thank you.
Now I welcome Toastmaster Shreya to present her speech. Toastmaster Shreya, divine timing. Divine timing, Toastmaster Shreya.
I would like to begin by asking you all a simple question using my virtual mic. I would like you all to unmute if you want to answer it. So here it is. Would you like to see your life through the new lenses of hope and adventure?
Yes.
Really good to hear that. Let's begin. Good evening, Toastmaster of the day, fellow Toastmasters. Today I'm going to speak on the topic divine timing. I love connecting the dots, and this is exactly what brought me to this topic of divine timing. Divine timing is the belief that everything in your life happens exactly at the right moment. Though events or people may seem tough and you may not be able to make sense out of it, but divine timing assures that the universe is placing people, things, and challenges into your life when you are ready to handle them. It's amazing to be able to see why something had to happen the way it did and how all of it led you here to this moment. So I would like to give you a few examples. So you may come across people telling you to read a book, or multiple people telling you the same thing again and again, or you running into the same person. So all this means something. This is exactly what happened to me last year. During the pandemic, I was seeing the name of this book, Autobiography of a Yogi, at almost all the places. And let me tell you that it was not because of the Google algorithm. People were recommending it to me. So I took it as a sign and thought of reading it. I started reading it. I found it quite interesting. But then, due to a few commitments, I had to leave it in between. And after a few months, I got a text from a friend of mine. I wasn't even in touch with this person for a long time. So I asked him what he was up to. And he said he was reading this book called Autobiography of a Yogi. And it came to me as a surprise, because he was somebody who used to hate reading books during the college time. So I started reading it again, and it's the primary reason why I'm speaking on this topic today. I got so busy with my life that I completely forgot about this concept, and I believe that I myself needed to get back to it. So why should you trust divine timing? It's an incredible feeling to know that you are being guided and things are really happening for a reason. There is always a reason for everything in your life. It is up to you to make sense out of it. So it is also important for you to know that you are a co-creator of your life, and you can create your life with the universe by seeing these things that are being put into your life at the divine timing and start working with them. The universe will never give you something that you are not ready for. But if you are somebody who loves to control things and you have a need to know that what is going to happen in the next moment, the whole concept of divine timing is difficult to wrap your head around. So here are a few tips for you. Firstly, you need to stop forcing things. You need to learn the art of letting go. If you cling onto something very tightly, then you are stopping something better, something new into coming to your life. You need to have a conviction that the universe will always provide you with the best and best of things. Secondly, be patient with it. You need to have patience in yourself. And just because something that you want is not coming right now does not mean it never will. It will come at exactly the moment you need it. It will come when you are ready to deal with it. Thirdly, don't overplan stuff. You don't need to know everything about your life. You don't need to know what is going to happen in the next moment. So stop planning for it. Just, I'm not asking you to not plan anything at all, but don't overplan things. Let life surprise you. Give it a chance. And lastly, I would just like to tell you all to surrender to the unknown, because that is where the magic begins. Thank you, everyone.
That was an amazing speech, Shreya. Now, our second speaker, Toastmaster Shirin, is going for an elogy speech. And to evaluate her speech, we have Toastmaster Anand.
Hello, am I audible and visible?
Yes, you are audible.
Okay. Not visible?
Yes, you are visible too.
Okay, thank you. So Toastmaster Shirin is attempting her eulogy speech from Level 3, Project 2 on delivering social speeches. The purpose of this project is for the member to practice delivering social speeches in front of club members. Timer, please note, timing is 3 to 4 minutes. Over to you, Toastmaster.
Thank you, Valuetaman. Toastmaster Shirin is going for an eulogy speech. Eulogy speech is a speech to honor the individual whose funeral service is going on. So in short, imagine this is a funeral service. Shirin has lost a dear friend and she will speak on the memories and the time she had with her friends. TM Shirin, cheers to the one. Cheers to the one, TM Shirin.
Oh, look at all the people who have turned up, which only helps me realize that how much my friend was cherished and loved. Even during this COVID times, you have taken up the time to come and attend her funeral service. If only she could see firsthand how many such lovely faces have come to honor her memories and to be with the family at this tough time, she would be so thrilled. So I would like to thank each and every one of you who have made the time to come. And it means a lot to all of us, for us and the family, that you have come and made your presence felt. Shirin, if I die, don't bring me flowers to my grave. Bring biryani, said my biryani enthusiast best friend, Ria. To all the people who know her closely, knows how much she loved her biryani. And her concept of living large was to eat a huge plate of biryani without guilt. Every Sunday, we would scout around in search of that perfect biryani. And at the end, we would eat so much that we could barely walk back home. She and me were totally different personalities. She was an early bird. I was a night owl. She was a rainbow and I was a dark cloud. She was sugar, spice and everything nice. She had good things to speak and she knew when to speak them. And in fact, even now, if she was at my place and I was there, she would have concocted such good memories, such good stories, anecdotes, and look at me, I'm not even able to string a few good sentences for her. But I know, she being my friend, even if I don't speak anything, she would understand me. Time may pass, places may change, people may leave, but memories last forever. She and the memories that she gave me, I cherish them. And cheers, Ria, to all the memories, to all the times that we had, the times when I was thrown out of class and you would come, you would do equally something wrong and get thrown out yourself so that you could give me company. The times when you would call late at night and kept blabbering on about your boyfriend, the times when we got our first job, the time when we celebrated like crazy with our first salary, and to all the times when I was falling apart and you held my hand throughout the journey. And the small things that you did for me, I now understand it's not about the big moments in life, but the small things that make life worth living. I may have lost the rainbow in my life, and a part of me might be lost, but I hope and pray each one of you get one friend, one good friend in your lives. And if not, I hope that you are a good friend to someone other. Ria, wherever you go and wherever you are, I promise not to be far away and always bring biryani with myself to you. Thank you, and over to you, Toastmaster of the Day.
That was an amazing, amazing speech, Toastmaster Shirin. Let's move forward. Our third speaker Toastmaster Kalpana. And to evaluate her speech, we have Toastmaster Sai Kumar. Toastmaster Sai Kumar, please read out her objective of speech.
Thank you, Toastmaster of the day. Toastmaster Kalpana is attempting level 3 first speech from the path strategic relationship, and the speech is introduction to Toastmasters mentoring. And the objective, the purpose of this project is for the member to clearly define how Toastmasters envisions mentoring. The purpose of this speech is for the member to share some aspect of a previous experience as a protege. Timer, please note the time limit is 5 to 7 minutes. I wish speaker all the best. Over to you.
Toastmaster Kalpana, Sculpted Diamond. Sculpted Diamond, Toastmaster Kalpana.
Hi. Am I audible and visible?
Yes, you are audible and visible.
All right. I think I'll start. And I chiseled away at my inner core with a hammer. It hurt, but I gripped the hammer strongly and continued with gritted teeth. Good evening, Toastmaster of the Day, fellow Toastmasters and guests. By profession, I am a trainer, a coach, and a mentor. Suddenly, I found myself into the shoes of a mentee when I joined Toastmasters. Actually, I'm still trying to recall what made me or what catapulted me into the forefront as a Toastmaster. Because when I joined the Toastmaster, my first thought was that I'm going to be a backbencher like a naughty child. So, was it my first role as a grammarian? Was it the challenge of writing a speech? Was it the challenge of relearning of delivering the speech? Was it the evaluations? Or was it the evaluations of the evaluators? Or was it a mentor? Of course, it was a mentor. If it hadn't been for diligent mentoring at the Toastmasters of the Speakers Community Toastmasters Club, I'm sure these awards that I have won would not have been easy. They mentored and handheld at every point as if I was taking my baby steps. When I joined in, I was like an uncupped diamond. And they started giving me polishes, cuts, and clarity. What did they do for me? They helped me deliver. They helped me write speech. They assisted me, gave me the knowledge about the working of the Toastmasters, and started shaping me into a future leader, not just personally, as well as professionally. They are mentors, not coaches. I wasn't here to learn to read and write, which is the job of a coach. These mentors, they actually hammer away your fears, your stigmas, your doubts, low confidence. They shape your inner core, your soul, so that you are a better person. It is like actually turning a bag inside out, much more better, much more neater. My very first mentor was Reuben Matthew. As I was lost as to what pathway I was going to take, he heard me out. He facilitated my thoughts, realized my potential, and guided me towards strategic relationships. There I was, catapulted from the backbencher to the front. Mentoring, they say, is actually a one-on-one relationship. Not so in Toastmasters. Everyone is a mentor to each other. And that is how Toastmaster Ankit became my mentor. Actually, at Toastmasters, he was my 911, my emergency call. He stopped me from my verbal diarrhea. He controlled my speech from Rajdhani to a normal train. He taught me the importance of time and to stay well within that time. Apart from that, I found the other members holding my hand and guiding me for various other roles. SAR role, timer role, table topics master role. When the competitions took place, I found myself elevated, representing my club and getting known to every Toastmasters of my country as I took up the role of MOC, CC, CJ. And then, of course, we even have tally counters. Tell me, I was getting more organized. I was getting more confident. And I was becoming a leader in an entirely different field. From my childhood, I have always thought and felt that mentoring is also self-induced. Hence, I had so many Toastmasters who helped me better myself. My very first Toastmaster who had my eyes wide in admiration was Toastmaster Sharon. There she was with the TMOD role, her inner core show, but she had command, courteous, and also cultured way of presenting and opening that meeting. Wow. Second Toastmaster who I accepted as my guru was Toastmaster Sachin. I suffer from procrastination. I procrastinate stuff for my next birth. If not today, tomorrow, day after tomorrow, later, or maybe next birth. And there it is on the Sunday, the meeting is over and I find Sachin has already sent me a message, you know, hey, roles for the upcoming Sunday. Toastmaster Parvati helped me simplify things. Toastmaster Manas taught me you can be a businessman, NGO, girl child education. You can be a speaker. You can be a Zoom master. I'm still chipping away at my own self-doubts. Dheeraj taught me how to have simple talks. Amai taught me what it is to network and be friends no matter after how long the gap we meet. Sai Kumar, I have listened to him so vigilantly, like my ears are open. It's like, lend me your ears. Why? Because Sai taught me how to evaluate each and every sentence, each and every action of a speaker. Without mentors and Toastmasters, none of us would be what we are. Leaders strapping and striding to go out there to conquer the world in every possible way. Thank you, mentors of the Toastmasters. Thank you. Over to you, Toastmaster of the Day.
Wonderful speech, Toastmaster Kalpana. Meanwhile, let's continue with the story. The potter. I was talking about the potter and the bag and the stone. The potter took the bag and the statue and gave to the king. King Chatur was amazed and glad to see the kind and generous act of the potter. He asked him to open the bag. The bag was stuffed with lots of gold coins. And a note from the king. The king note said that the bag was a reward for removing the stone from the road. The potter was very happy. The king also announced that the artist will take the contract to paint the kingdom that year. In the story, an obstacle which seemed to be a problem for the rest turned out to be an opportunity for the poor artist. So does happens to our life. There are many obstacles that
we may face in our life, but it is up to us how we face them and turn them into an opportunity to succeed in our life. Now let us begin with the next session of the day. The next session of the day, I'll call Toastmaster Dheeraj to address the table topic session. Toastmaster Dheeraj.
Thank you, Toastmaster Anisha. Good evening, Toastmaster of the day. Hello, Toastmaster and the guests. I am Dheeraj Singh and I am the table topic master for today's session. This is an impromptu speech session of Toastmaster meeting. And it is an interesting session which will give you a chance to hone your listening, thinking, organizing and speech delivery skills. For table topic, the time allotted is 1 to 2 minutes. Green card will be shown after 1 minute, yellow after 1.5 minutes, and red after 2 minutes. A grace period of 30 seconds is given to qualify for the vote. Speaker has to speak minimum for 1 minute to qualify for the vote. All the speakers are requested to use the word of the day and the phrase of the day. I encourage all the members as well as the guests to volunteer for the session. Now let us begin with the session. So do we have any volunteers for this session? I have a strong conviction that you all will willingly take up the role.
Yes.
Okay, so who is the first one? Okay. So to Zoom Master, can you help me with the, who is the first one? To this?
Sorry, this is who? Actually, no one has raised their hand.
Actually,
yeah, Kalpana. Yes, Kalpana.
Yes, Kalpana. We can add Kalpana. Okay. So, Zoom Master, please spotlight Toastmaster Kalpana. Kalpana, Toastmaster Kalpana, your topic is learning from Gandhi's ideology.
Learning from
Gandhi's ideology. Over to you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Dheeraj, for that lovely topic. Gandhi is actually my idol. Yeah. Gandhi is idol, actually my idol. And the very first thing that I always think of Gandhi is a story that I had come across when I was a child, read it in Gandhi's autobiography, actually. Mahatma Gandhi, I think, was slapped one day by someone. Such a righteous person, instead of slapping him back, he had offered his other cheek saying, why don't you slap the other cheek too? Hence, embarrassing the person who had slapped him. Till a certain period of my own life, I was like that with my mom, who decided to either scold me or thrash me up. I gave up my second cheek and used to tell her, why don't you slap me on this cheek too? That influenced I was with Mahatma Gandhi. I enjoyed his truthfulness, his nonviolence movement that he started across India to ensure that the Britishers left our country and we won our independence. Europeans, especially Germans and other countries, have actually taken up his policies of nonviolence to combat with today's generation's bloodthirsty revenge attitude that has cropped up. If we really need to live peacefully and face our life with distinction or, you know, with peace, we should all actually adopt to Gandhian values and principles. Thank you, Dheeraj. Over to you.
That was a wonderful speech. What I can say is thappar sidda nahi lagta yourself.
Yes.
Okay, so do we have any next volunteer?
Yes, Sai Kumar.
Okay, Sai Kumar is there. So Zoom Master, please contact the Sai Kumar. Sai Kumar, let's have a quick audio video check.
Hello, am I audible?
Yes, you are audible as well as visible. Are you able to see the timer cards?
Yeah.
So the topic for you is, Sai Kumar, hope is not a plan. Hope is not a plan. Over to you, Toastmaster Sai Kumar.
Hope is not upfront.
not a plan.
Not a plan.
Yes.
Thank you, table topic master. Hope is not a plan. We all plan something in our day-to-day life with a hope of belief, conviction, and determination. But do you think hope and plan always travels together? Sometimes yes, and sometimes no. It's like a two sides of a coin, head and tail. Just now, in the first session, one speaker said, do not plan so much. Just chill the current time and plan a bit, because you never know what is going to happen tomorrow or day after tomorrow. So hope is not a plan, but what I would say, which related to our day-to-day work, as I know, we need to plan at least for something where we can be safe, we can see ourselves safe in a good position or in all prospects of life. Example, till 2 years back, I was not planning at all in terms of maybe my future savings, all were nil. But this 1.5 year has taught me a lesson. Two things you always plan. Save something, at least 5 to 10% from your income, because that is what you will be having in your near future. And with hope and conviction and determination, you will achieve it. So I would say, since hope is not a plan, but there are times where you have to plan a bit, not go to the extreme hand as someone said, but you need to be somewhere at medium and proportionate level to have a balance of hope and plan. Thank you. Over to topic master.
Thank you, Toastmaster Sahib. That was a very compelling speech, and I agree that we should have a financial planning and we should not beat around the bush. We should save 10 to 15%. Okay, so do we have next volunteer? Okay, huh, so Shreya is there, Toastmaster Shreya. Let's have a quick audio video check.
Yes, am I audible and visible?
Yeah, you are audible as well as visible. Are you able to see the timer cards?
Yes.
So the topic for you is importance of non-violence.
Importance of
non-violence.
Non-violence. So I am a firm believer that you don't need to use violence as your weapon for sorting things out. You can even use your words. Your words are powerful enough to make an impact on anybody. And I myself am trying to use them. I don't use my hands when I am fighting with somebody. I don't fight with people, but in case there is some disagreement, which is very normal because different people have different perceptions, which sometimes lead to disagreement, then I use my words in order to make the other person understand why I feel the way I feel. And I believe that nobody is right or wrong. It's just about perception. I think something about a matter because that is how it has always been for me. Then you can use your words to change my mind. You don't need to use your hands in order to spread, like in order to make me believe that you are right. So this is it for today. Over to you, Toastmaster. DTM Dheeraj.
Yet I am not a DTM. And that was a very wonderful speech. We should understand the power of God. And I believe in dissolving the conflict by mutual discussions. So do we have any next volunteer? Yeah, so we have a guest, Sagarika. So, Toastmaster, please spotlight guest Sagarika. Am I pronouncing your name properly? You are on mute, Sagarika.
Hello.
Now you are audible. Zoom master, please spotlight. So, are you able to see the timer cards?
No, not yet. Yeah, you're right. Now? Yes, yes. I can see the white screen.
Yeah, white, and then green will be displayed after 1 minute, and you have to speak minimum for 1 minute. Okay. So the topic for you is change or bring the change.
I cannot hear.
Hello.
Hello.
Am I audible to you?
Little soft it is. Okay. Hello.
Is it okay now? Am I audible right now?
Yeah.
Okay. So the topic for you is change or bring the change. Again, repeat. Change or bring the change. What do you do? Yes.
Change or bring the change.
Yes.
Okay. So I have to talk on this only.
Yes.
All right. This is a difficult topic, actually. Okay.
If you want, I can change it for you. If you want, I can give you a different topic.
Okay. Give me an option.
The meaning of life.
Would rather write. Say okay, the
so you go
yeah change
okay, so you go with the, or bring the
change. Yeah, change or bring the change. Okay, well, we as humans are God's highest form of creation, and I believe every human being has a responsibility to find out his or her own treasures, use these treasures to make the world a better place. So I am convinced over the years, it's my conviction that as I am evolving as a human being, that I believe that this world has to have people who brings about change in terms of greater service to humanity by utilizing their own innate qualities, the God-gifted qualities and skills to help every human being in every walk of life. So that is my that is the reason why human beings are on this earth. They exist to bring change. The universe is under constant change. It is constantly revolving and rotating. That means it's in a progressive motion. So if we human beings don't change with times, we are actually stagnating ourselves. So rather than going into paths or into a tradition of dogmatic tradition of following certain regimes or rules, we need to bring change in our mindsets, in the way we live, in the way we serve others, to make this world a better place. So I believe it's either we need to change as human beings or we need to help others to change to make the world a better place for mankind to exist. Because as time has increased, as time evolves, there are greater challenges to face. Thank you.
Thank you, guest Sagarika. That was a wonderful speech. And I agree that change is the only constant. And women has an intellect and the power to change the society in a positive way. Okay, so do we have any other volunteer? Anyone from the guest? Okay, so we have a Gramedian.
Yeah, there is. I will go for that. Just a minute.
Okay.
So can you need to put me on spotlight? I cannot.
just a minute. I think that you are now on spotlight.
Yes, try it out. I just on my video. Just go to my name, right hand side on three dot. You just click on that three dot and add me spotlight. Yes. That.
Okay, so let me share my screen first. Are you able to see the avatars?
Yeah.
So the speech title for you is Humbleness, a Weakness or a Power? Humbleness, a Weakness or Power? Over to you, Toastmaster once.
I am used to go to Mandir on different kind of Mandirs. I do not know it is just habituated. On Monday, I just go to Shiv Mandir. On Tuesday, I go to Dev Mandir, Devi Mandir, that Ganesh Ji Mandir. And on Saturday, I go to that Saneshwar Mandir. And what I saw, that there were a lot of beggars in front of the temple. So 10 years back, I was that kind of person. When I told them that why not you people are working? But when I read a lot of books, I just go through a lot of seminars, I learned that I'm not supposed to tell them. Because if I am able to give them work, then I am supposed to tell them. I will give you the work, then come to us. But it's our humbleness that we, if someone asks something, and because he or she asked something to you, can you go on mute, please? As per that person's, you are the eligible to give them. So you need to show your humanity, you need to be humble for that, and need to be give something, whatever in your, you know, capacity. So humbleness is a strength, or humbleness is a weakness. It is not about the strength, it is not about the weakness, it is on your mind. Because I am that Manas 10 years back who told that you need to work it out. I am the same Manas after 10 years who just take my wallets and give some things. So it's about us, how we need to show our humanity. Thank you. Over to you, Toastmaster of the day. Hey, Table Topic Master.
Thank you, Toastmaster Manas. That was a wonderful speech, and I believe that humbleness is a human perspective. It's not a weakness or strength. So, do we have any other volunteer? So as we do not have any volunteer, I conclude this session. So, timer. Please present the report. As I myself is a timer, so I will be presenting the timing report. So Kalpana took 1 minute 35 seconds. Sai took 2 minutes 13 seconds. Shreya took 1 minute 10 seconds. Guest Sagarika took 1 minute 35 seconds. And Toastmaster Manas took 2 minutes 10 seconds. All are eligible for voting. So the Zoom master, please raise the poll. Be ready for the voting. In the meanwhile, I hand over the stage to the Toastmaster of the day, Toastmaster Anisha. Thank you. Over to you, Toastmaster.
Yes, poll is launched.
Thank you, Manas. Everyone is requested to please submit the poll. Meanwhile, I hand over the stage to the Toastmaster.
Just 1 minute, Dheeraj, I just remove you from that co-host. Actually, all people are just getting same votes. It's a tie between all. So your vote is, that I will just remove you from your...
Okay, I will be the film maker.
Dheeraj, can you give the times of prepared speeches?
At times, I will do it at the time of general evaluation.
Sure. Should I start with the session?
Yes, please proceed.
Meanwhile, I would like to highlight the names of few people who overcome obstacles in life and achieve great success. It was Walt Disney who overcome poverty and become the world leading producer and provider in entertainment. He was Abraham Lincoln who overcome chronic depression in life and served as the president of America in his life. She was Helen Keller, who was the first blind deaf to earn bachelor degree in arts and become a prominent author, activist, and lecturer. He was Nick Vigil, who is having a rare disorder of absence of arms and legs, but he's a swimmer and a motivational speaker. And there are a lot many. Eventually, there are obstacles who might lead to opportunities. If we face them as a problem to move forward towards our dream, if we do not face them. Now, I hand it over the stage to our journal evaluator, Toastmaster Sai Kumar.
Thank you, Toastmaster of the Day, for the thought-provoking message. Now, my role as a general evaluator is to evaluate everything that takes place during the meeting. So general evaluation has been critical thinking and time management skill. So first, to evaluate the session, evaluate the speeches, I have a set of evaluators and tag team. So first, I will start the evaluation round. The first speech was given by Toastmaster Shreya, and to evaluate her speech, may I invite Toastmaster Manas on stage? Toastmaster Manas?
Yeah. Over to you. So, just 1 minute. Actually, Dheeraj, where is Dheeraj?
Yes.
Just 2 minutes, generally, evaluator. Dheeraj, can you put me on spotlight, please?
So before Dheeraj share the spotlight, can I invite timer to share the timing report of speeches, first prepared speeches.
Okay, so the timing report of prepared speeches is as follows. Toastmaster Shreya took 5 minutes 16 seconds. Second speaker, Toastmaster Sharon, took 3 minutes 50 seconds. The third speaker, Toastmaster Kalpana, took 7 minutes 8 seconds. All are eligible for vote.
All are eligible, so you can cast vote to either one.
So Manas will take this after his evaluation.
Yeah. After this evaluation, you can launch a poll for the prepared speech round.
Yes. So, yes, Dheeraj, you can put me on.
Today, I'm not able to get an option of spotlighting you. Just I can pin you.
Okay, general evaluator, if you permit me, can I go ahead?
Yeah, please.
Yeah, thank you. So thank you, general evaluator. Hello, everyone. The secret of getting ahead is getting started. This is as per our great philosopher, Mark Twain. Nowadays, all our beliefs on this and put different words to express their thoughts to agree philosopher Mark Twain's belief. So, hi Shreya, when I heard your speech title, suddenly I remember what Sadhguru says on this. As per Sadhguru, it is the time to enhance your ability to transcend limitations better because your energies are in state of flux. So as a successpreneur coach, I always told my students that divine time is the best time to create yourself. You crafted your speech so well that I refreshed myself and enjoyed a lot to know what a person can do in this time and what they should not. Also, I came to know something different why they should believe divine timing. All came out from their bit around the bus. What I like in your speech is that you tried to start with a powerful technique to ease the audience into listening to you and staying with you throughout the speech. I love you, Rick, as a journalist, just so that the speaker. Ladies and gentlemen, when Toastmaster Shreya shared her experience in divine time, she trying to point out how she reached at this point. When she does this, she brought us all along on a journey. But more importantly, Toastmaster Shreya, you speak with a conviction. When you did this, brought yourself closer to all of us and included us in your speech. Great job. You are putting your best and try to touch the importance of time. Your voice clarity is good. You appear comfortably with the audience. Your body language also too good. Overall, your speech is a blessing of all who have not any time to do. But every coin has two parts. You may want to work on your body language only. You need to work on controlling your hands. Unnecessary movement distracts the audience. If you can add something to inspire all to follow the divine timing, learning from your speech or why audience also need to follow them, then it could be have tadka on your speech. I like to give you challenge here that you just do some things on your Zoom background. Do some things on your attire to match your speech title so that audience can remember your speech by remembering some pictures too. So thank you Shreya, and all the best for your future speeches. Over to you, General Evaluator.
Thank you, Toastmaster Vanas, for this wonderful evaluation. Now moving on to the second speech. The second speech was delivered by Toastmaster Sherin. And to evaluate her speech, may I invite Toastmaster Anand on stage. Toastmaster Anand, the stage is all yours.
Yeah, am I audible and visible?
Yeah.
Okay, can I see the timer class, please? Can you flip it through? Okay. Thank you. Today, Toastmaster Sherin delivered a heartwarming speech that helped me realize the importance of appreciating friendships, not just when they are around, but even beyond. Thank you, Sherin. COVID situation has left most of us with less number of friends due to their untimely departure. And I could really connect with your speech and brought back beautiful memories of some of my close friends who are no longer with us. And you have definitely achieved the purpose in delivering a strong message of appreciating in life and beyond. Secondly, delivering a eulogy is overwhelming, especially when the deceased is a beloved relative or a close friend. Sometimes personal emotions can cloud clear thinking and self-control. While delivering such a speech, one may wonder whether to keep the tone solemn or keep it light. You struck a nice balance between the both and interspersed the speech by bringing out the humor and lighter times you shared with your friend Ria, appreciating and relieving the memories of being thrown out of the class the time, the late night calls and so on. However, the thing that comes to the top of my mind about death is the depiction by the character Anand from the same movie, Anand. Babu Moshai, Zindagi Lambi Nahi Badi Honi Chahiye. This Bollywood dialogue has a universal appeal. And in one of his last speech, Martin Luther King Jr. prophetically noted that the quality, not the longevity of one's life, is what is important. And you did touch upon this most important facet of life, of how Rhea liked living life large, and specifically sharing the love for biryani. Sharon, I really do not have any recommendations for your speech. While delivering a social speech, it's important that you just be yourself, and that is enough. No one to judge you for the relationship you shared with your friend Rhea. Sharon, I really admire and respect you for delivering this eulogy, as it is really challenging to present such a sensitive speech in a difficult situation. Over to you, gentlemen.
Thank you, Toastmaster Anand, for the wonderful evaluation. The third speaker was Toastmaster Kalpana, and I will be evaluating her speech. Introduction to Toastmaster's mentoring. The speech which shook me, connected, and got engaged, because all the audience present in this room are very much related to mentoring and its importance. And that is what today Toastmaster Kalpana, in 7 minutes, 10 seconds, explained to us the importance of having mentor in our life. So congratulations, Toastmaster Kalpana, for this message, how you conveyed the value and essence of Toastmaster mentoring. And what I like means about this speech, the mentoring, you shared the examples of our Toastmaster journey of 7 months from where you started, and what are the things you learned from all the members. And what I like, you define specifically what each and every member taught you as a mentor. You shared examples of your first mentor and even DTM Ankit, how with related to your delivery, with related to voice, with related to your speech flow, and all the various roles played in Toastmasters, how the mentoring had played and changed you as a speaker. And the interest of audience was also there, because in this room, as I said, the interest of audience was related to Toastmasters. So you had the audience awareness, and the clarity of your speech was well done. And I also liked the concept you brought in, like why I should join first Toastmasters mentoring and how it benefited me in terms of the value of importance of mentor. Your delivery, you had your delivery flow and eye contact with the audience was superb, and I could connect with you easily. Now in mentoring, what we say is a relay button where we learn and we share with others. So how you can enlighten one or two things in the same speech by how you implemented the learnings of mentoring in your personal or professional journey. Example, you said that you are a coach trainer. Have you implemented and changed any one person whom you saw has some kind of difficulty, maybe communication or leadership, and added two lines which could have added a little bit impact on the speech. Overall, to summarize, I would say, Toastmaster Kalpana, through this speech, you had a good connect, good clarity of thought, and overall the concept of the speech with related to audience awareness was superb. Just add a little bit about how you can apply this mentoring skill in your personal or Toastmaster, or have you any mentored any mentee, which you can share some experience. I'm sure you could have taken this speech from one level to the other level. Congratulations, all the best for your speeches. Thank you. So that concluded the evaluation round. Moving on, let us hear what our tag team has to say. So may I invite the timer to give the timing report of evaluation round.
Thank you, General Evaluator. You must please spotlight me. So the timing report of speaker is as follows. Toastmaster Shreya took 516 seconds. Toastmaster Sharon, which is the second speaker, took 3:50. Speaker 3, Toastmaster Kalpana, took 7:08.
For the evaluation that was part, already given about yes, the speakers. I'm talking about the
evaluators. Evaluator 1, Toastmaster Anand, took 2:48. Evaluator 2, Toastmaster... Evaluator 1, Toastmaster Manas, took 2:48. Evaluator 2, Toastmaster Anand, took 3:06. And Evaluator 3, Toastmaster Sai Kumar, took 3:26. So all are eligible for voting.
All the evaluators are eligible for voting for the best evaluator. So I would request the Zoom master to cast a poll for first for the best prepared speeches and then followed by evaluation. Okay, in the meantime, till that he prepares the poll, we can have the report from our counter. May I invite Toastmaster Anisha to present the R-Counter report.
Yes. So the report goes like this. Speaker 1, Shreya, 2 two repeated words, and 1 short pause. Speaker 2, Kalpana, 2 1 bell, and 3 short pauses. Speaker 3, Toastmaster Shirin, 3 1 repeated word. Toastmaster Sai Kumar, 1 Guest Sagrika, 2 1 and 1 short pause. Toastmaster Manas, 2 2 so, and 2 repeated words, and 1 short pause. Evaluator Anand, 1 That's about it.
Thank you, Toastmaster Anisha. So let's hear the last tag member, Toastmaster Amay, to present the grammarian tip.
Yes, am I audible and visible?
Yeah.
Okay. First of all, before starting with the report, I would like to thank all the speakers and evaluators for their wonderful speeches. It was really difficult for me to keep a close watch and to hear the different phrases and words which everyone used. So please excuse me and consider me if I miss out some words and phrases which almost all the speakers, evaluators, and our guests used. So I would begin by reading the names of our Toastmasters who used the word of the day. So Toastmaster Sai Kumar, Toastmaster Shreya, Toastmaster Sharon, Toastmaster Kalpana, Toastmaster Manas, and Toastmaster Dheeraj used word of the day. I would also thank Dheeraj for appropriately using the phrase of the day as well. And our guest Sagarika used the word of the day. Now, the words which I noted down, which sounded really meaningful during the speeches were by Toastmaster Shreya. She used wrap your head around a phrase, then cling on to something. This phrase she used. And then Toastmaster Sharon, that speech really touched. And she there were two words, blabbering and falling apart. Then Toastmaster Kalpana used the phrases like found myself in the shoes of mentee, then caterpillated, deleging, uncut diamond, and chipping away. Also in table topics, she used the word thrash. Then Toastmaster Manas used the phrase given by Sadhguru. Unfortunately, I was not able to catch up with that phrase. So please consider me. That was amazing. And the transcending was the word something which I noticed. Then Toastmaster Anand, again, sorry, because there was some kind of technical glitch. So I was not able to hear your voice properly. But whatever you said also touched, because that was amazing. In slow words, you actually, you know, remembered the people which are not with us today. Then, so this was all about the grammarian report. Thank you so much. Over to you, Toastmaster.
Yeah. Thank you, Toastmaster Amay, for the detailed grammarian report. Now I'll present my general evaluation report. The session started on time. Though we were falling short of all the role bearers, so many role bearers took multiple roles. And firstly, I appreciate all the role bearers here for taking more than one role. Good job. Starting with Zoom Master and Sergeant at Arms Toastmaster Manas. Firstly, you took the double role, and I would say we always say as energetic, we know Manas. You opened the meeting room also half an hour in advance, where you explained the set ground rule and all the instruction to all the members and guests present in the room. Presiding officer Toastmaster Sherin, today I read you took this role as a presiding officer at the last moment. Appreciate, great job done. And also I would like to tell a speaker taking the role of presiding officer and any other role is highly commendable. Great job done. And also you shared, the speaker interacted with the audience and shared some inspirational stories. Now in every Toastmaster meeting, what we say, there are guests. Just to connect and interact with them, you shared the story and had a good interaction with us. Though we were not having guests in the beginning, but you connected well. Good job, Toastmaster Sharing. Toastmaster Anisha introduced the structure and the flow of Toastmaster meeting. And then, good thing, then you spoke about your theme, obstacle to opportunity. What I like about your speech also, you divided your story into 2 to 3 segments and you shared the story. Now, what I would personally feel or a suggestion you could have add here means, you should get some information with all the role bearers with related to theme, and you can introduce with that question and answer with all the role bearers for just interactive with all the role bearers. Like you had a theme opportunity where you could have asked before this, prior to 1 or 2 days, to all the club role bearers speak, tell one line or two lines about the personal or professional opportunities which you face in your life. In this way, you could have introduced your portal. Great job done. And the second, once all the prepared speeches are over, the T-mode gives the ask for the timing report of prepared speech. Then we move to the second round. Here, I called the timer to present the timing report of the first prepared speech round. But generally in Toastmaster meeting, after the speeches are over, T-modes ask the timer to present the timing report of first prepared speech round. So that was done in the third round. Coming to role bearers, Toastmaster Dheeraj, again, double role, I would say. Dheeraj explained the guidelines of all the 3 segments very well. Our counter, Anisha, congratulations again, double role. Kudos. Difficult to do both the roles, T-mode and the R-counter. And what I like about you, apart from doing your T-mode role, you also had a detailed and crisp report of each and every R-counter of every members to count their filler words. Great job done. Toastmaster Amay, the grammarian for today. So Toastmaster Amay introduced the word of the day, and he also dropped a message in the chat box so that audience and our guests and members can come to know the word of the day and phrase of the day. And what I like, the word of the day and phrase of the day were very simple, mostly each and every role bearers use word of the day in their speeches. Great job done, and good minute observation of all the phrases in between where the speakers connected with the audience. Thank you, Toastmaster Amay. And coming to table topic master, Toastmaster Dheeraj, again, this was a double role because you were the timer also and did the role of a table topic master. What I like here about table topic master, the topics were good, like very, very simple. And each and every member can easily speak for 1 minute. So your topic selection was very good. Now in Toastmasters script, if you see, there are four things: listening, thinking, organizing and planning, delivering. These are the skill set which helps in table topic speeches. So you could have added, introduce the audience with these four skills. All the speeches were very good, I would say it, and very, very different speeches we heard about the time, about the eulogy and the importance of mentoring. So all the speeches, variety of speeches by all the three speakers, very good. And all the evaluators followed the CRC method. So in suggestion, I would have like when new members or guests are added, either team mode or the role bearers in between can explain the timing guidelines also for the specific round. When it was table topic round, I think some member asked, do we need to speak the same topic or about the timing? Could I explain? And during the meeting also, any role bearers can tell, apart from the role bearers, others can go on mute. Because in the today's meeting, we heard some kind of noise and disturbance in the while the speaker was speaking. So that was my observation as a general evaluator. What I want to conclude means, today we had less members, less count, but kudos to all the role bearers for taking multiple roles and conducting this session. Because as a mentor, mentee, as a member, we all learn. The session should go on, and it happened today. Thank you to all the XCOM for arranging this session at the last minute and making so many changes. Hope in our upcoming sessions, we have the role bearers ready at least 2 to 3 days well in advance, so that in the agenda also we can mention the names that we saw many places where TBD to be decided, and we can just minimize the gap, this gap. Thank you. Over to Toastmaster of the day. Our presiding officer is taking up.
Yes, I think I will take it up. Since we all are here, I request everyone to switch on their videos so that I can take a screenshot. Anisha? Just let me know, Manas, when it's done.
Yes, we've done.
Okay, great. I think we are remaining with the polls that are remaining are role players and auxiliary role players. Can we launch them also?
This is for auxiliary role players.
Yes, I think we are done with the polls and we have a guest with ourselves. Sagarika, I think she is joining us for the second time. So Sagarika, how did you enjoy the meeting? How did you feel about it? I think you are on mute.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Am I audible?
Yes.
Yeah. So today I got a greater grasp about the protocol that is followed. And last time I was a bit confused. Although today my audio is not working too well and I have got some renovation going up. I'm a little hard of hearing today. So anyhow, I enjoyed every person's. And I'm learning from all of you. I was really nervous when my topic of the table topic was given to me. I really didn't know how to fit my points within the specific time allotted, because it was like change or bring change, either change or bring change. So I wanted to incorporate a lot of points anyhow. Somehow I managed something. I don't know how good it was. Just trying my best. And
I understand there is an audio issue there, and with the things that I heard, I understand you want to say that the table topic session, you wanted to add a lot more things, and somehow you managed with the things. We also have educational sessions wherein it is a technique of how to add a lot of points when you're given a table topic is being said. So this kind of educational sessions also go in. So it might happen some time in the future. We'll surely call you. Hope that you would be a Toastmaster by then. And with this, I would request Manas, if the certificates are ready, we can show them.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, is my screen is visible to all of you?
It's loading.
Oh, it's network. Is it visible right now?
No, it's still loading, Manas.
Oh,
yes. Yeah, we can see it now. So the role player auxiliary, the best role player auxiliary goes to Toastmaster Amay. Amay, you'd smile.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Okay, the best speaker goes to me. Thank you. Thank you so much. the best table topics goes to Toastmaster Kalpana. Congratulations, Kalpana. Best evaluator goes to Toastmaster Anand. Thank you, Anand, for being a part of this meeting, and congratulations.
Thank you. I guess it's the third time speaker evaluator combination.
Great. Hope to see you more.
Yes. Thank you.
Are we done with the certificates, Manan?
Just 1 minute. I need to take the photographs. Just 1 minute.
Okay. Just let me know when you're done.
Yeah, it is Anisha.
Okay, the best role player goes to our T-Mod, Toastmaster Anisha. Okay, I think we are done with all the certificates. With that, the next meeting will be on 10th, the next Sunday, from 4 to 5:45. Thank you, everyone. And I declare and I close the meeting. We are, the session is on for networking. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Well done.
Thank you.